Ian here with IBC Technologies. Today we're going to show you how to connect a dry contact call for heat to the boiler and how to connect the corresponding pump for that call for heat. To wire a dry contact call for heat to the boiler, we are going to wire all the low voltage wiring to the TB2 terminal. The corresponding high voltage is then wired from the TB1 terminal. Position number 5 is your common for a dry contact enable, and then position 6, 7, 8 and 9 are the four loads that you can set up. Correspondingly, if you wire a dry contact call for heat to number 5 and 6 on therm 1, when that dry contact closes, it will energize PV1 or pump number 1 with a live and a neutral for the pump. Correspondingly, if you wire dry contact to 5 and 7, when that dry contact closes, it will energize the PV2 relay on the TB1 terminal with a live and a neutral for the pump. The relay on the board is rated at 10 amps, and the fuse for that particular pump is rated at 5 amps. If you are using a domestic hot water sensor, then the sensor will be wired into position 17 and 18 on the TB2 terminal. And this is just for a 10 k-ohm type 2 thermistor for domestic hot water activation. If you are using an aquastat for your domestic call for heat, that will be wired into number 5 and the corresponding number 6, 7, 8 or 9, depending on the pump that you have wired to the TB1 terminal.